So Verstappen started at only 10th in Hungary, a track that has been notoriously difficult to overtake on in the past, and things look pretty bleak. This is why Max started 10th. George Russell's pole lap in the blue, Max Verstappen's first attempt in the red, and his second attempt in Q3 in the green. So it's pretty rare that a driver is left with no decent laps in Q3 with two attempts. But you can see the red one first, Max Verstappen on his first run, and he just goes in way too deep into turn two here. Carries in way more speed than Russell's pole lap, and it results in a big lock-up, ran wide, lost the lap. And it just looks like Max then just attacking a little bit too much. The entry speed, his actual brake pressure wasn't as high as George Russell's, but he's just braking later, and he's turning in a little bit earlier as well. So Max then too ambitious on his first run into turn two, lost the lap, but then he's still had a second run to try and take that pole position that Red Bull looked to be in the mix for. But then you can see the green line here is the aborted second attempt. And you can clearly see here, Max has no top speed in the green. He's full on throttle. Again, coming out of the corner, he's actually fully on throttle at this point, but the power unit's just not picking up. And Red Bull spotted an issue with it across the board, actually. And they changed all the power units in the Red Bull cars and the AlphaTauri cars, which only meant at the time a penalty for Pierre Gasly, who had a pit lane start. But it will probably be a problem later on for Red Bull. But as it was, just a difficult Saturday, and it left them with a lot of work to do on Sunday.
We are ready, and everyone is lined up on the grid for the Hungarian Grand Prix.
Starting from 10th is always a tricky place to start. Right in the midfield pack, and particularly in Hungary, it's a long run to the first corner and quite a tight corner when you get there as well. The cars all concertina and pack in together. So we can see on board with Max, he's pretty cautious as he gets away. He's on the soft tyre, so Red Bull gave him quite a punchy strategy here between Bottas and Ricciardo. He's actually had a decent start, but he's very cautious at this point. We've seen so many times where drivers get squeezed together and the one on the inside reacts too late. So Max doesn't want to put himself in that position. You've got Sergio Perez steaming around the outside. And then, because he's been quite cautious, we've actually got Kevin Magnussen now trying to make a move on Verstappen through turn one. And it's actually not gone well this start, but he gets a bit of a reprieve there. Fernando Alonso chopping across the front of Daniel Ricciardo, and Verstappen then takes advantage of that. And this is how close it was for Ricciardo, fighting on the outside, and Alonso just cuts straight across, fighting his own rear of the car, the McLaren. And then Verstappen's later on the brakes and into turn two. And this was Kevin Magnussen getting pretty unlucky as well in this moment. Alonso cuts across, Ricciardo backs off, and Magnussen just has a small bit of contact with him and actually makes a brilliant move into turn two here, squeezing between Bottas, Ricciardo, and his teammate on the inside. Gets himself up into the top 10, but will get a black and orange flag for that bit of damage that he had on his front wing end plate again this season. So Magnussen unlucky, Ricciardo lost out, and it all helped Max Verstappen clear a couple of midfield cars at this stage. Then he passes Sergio Perez on the first lap as well into the chicane. Nice move, Perez compliant, didn't put up a huge fight. Side through the Alpines as well on the medium tyre. The soft was a good choice for Red Bull, and it left Max in a pretty decent position then by the time we get to the first stops. And we've spoken a lot about strategy this year. A lot of times Ferrari haven't got it right, and a few times Red Bull have nailed it. Monaco was one of them, and Hungary was another. Really good strategy from Red Bull in Budapest, and we can see it here, the graph. And this is really what brought Verstappen back into play. Good driving from Max, very fast when he needed to be, but also good decisive thinking from the Red Bull pit wall. And it starts on this first pit stop. Verstappen tucked in behind Lewis Hamilton. They've both cleared Lando Norris, but because they've been stuck behind Lando early on, there's a gap formed between Hamilton and the top three, who are fighting it out quite closely at the front. So the first to pit is Verstappen with George Russell out front. But Verstappen here pits early, And he basically just undercuts Hamilton at this point, which gives him a lot of space then to drive into and use the pace of the Red Bull in the second stint of the Grand Prix, which, as you can see towards the latter part there, it brings him right into play with Russell and Sainz, because he managed to clear Lewis Hamilton's Mercedes in that first stop. So it was good effort then from Red Bull to be proactive in the pit stops. But they were proactive again in the second stop. And you can see here, this is the one that ended up deciding the Grand Prix, really. Leclerc at this point is in control of the race. He's passed Russell on track. The Ferrari looks the quickest car at this stage. on the medium tyres, Charles is pulling away. But Verstappen again takes the plunge. Red Bull ran a pretty short middle stint in this Grand Prix, and Max dives in for another set of tyres, followed on the next lap by George Russell and Charles Leclerc. And Red Bull were clever at this point because Ferrari couldn't cover off with Sainz. It was already lost by the time Sainz pitted, and so Red Bull pitted, and Max came out actually ahead of George Russell, which was a good effort from a good couple of seconds back. And that is down to some good skill from the driver as well. This is the outlaps then of Verstappen compared to Russell. And you can see how much more Max is pushing than George on this outlap. He's really got the confidence in the car, medium tyres compared to medium tyres. And he's just attacking all pretty much everywhere around this lap. He's so much quicker. First of all, he's good on the brakes into the early part of the lap. He's so much quicker through these high speed corners as well. And it makes up a massive difference on George Russell's in-lap, but this is just a reference to the out-lap to show just how quick Max was on his out-lap, making up the difference to the Mercedes. So he jumped one Mercedes in the first stop, and he jumps the second Mercedes in the second stop. The only thing now is a Ferrari out front, but the hard tyre pretty much took care of that for Verstappen. So Ferrari were in quite a tricky position in the Grand Prix. Leading the race, great. Done everything right at that point, but they hadn't used anything other than a medium tyre. So to get to the end on both cars, they had to either stick on a soft or a hard. And what they did was react to the track position of Verstappen and cover him off with the effectively the lead of the race at that stage with Leclerc. But the only tyre that could get Leclerc to the end of the Grand Prix at that point was the hard. Sainz went the different way. He was already undercut by Verstappen and he tried to go in the end for the soft tyre and leave the hard alone. Because in Hungary, the hard tyre just wasn't working. And we can see that from this move then, that Verstappen's going to put on Leclerc for effectively the lead of the Grand Prix. Lining up Charles Leclerc at the end of Leclerc's outlap, struggling to get the temperature into the tyres with Charles, but even then, the hards were very difficult to keep in the window, and Max immediately has DRS, and he's got a great chance to pass inside or outside. But we just get a really clear demonstration of the grip difference of the medium and the hard tyres. Leclerc tries to go with Verstappen into the first corner. We've seen many great battles between the two this year, but actually this time, there's just no grip for him. And he turns in, trying to get the switch back here and drive back towards Verstappen into turn two. And he's just having to fight the car, making a big opposite lock into turn one. He's just got no rear end grip at all. And it just allows Max to drive away on the exit and take the lead. And what should have been a comfortable win at that point. And it was down basically to the strategy then of Ferrari, who didn't start on the soft tyres, as Verstappen had done and Russell had done in the Mercedes, but then went for the hard tyre, which they could have already maybe seen was struggling quite a lot in the hands of the Alpines earlier on in the race. But they opted for it for the track position, but it was null and void by the time that Leclerc was out there scrabbling around with very minimal grip. But the grip was pretty low for everyone. And Max, on the next lap, has this spin. And it's a really, it's an odd one to see. You don't see too many unforced errors of this type. And he didn't look like he did a huge amount wrong, just gently nudging the throttle coming through turn 13. He's got plenty of steering angle on at the time, but that's absolutely normal for this long radius corner. And then the car goes. And Max just, at this point, full opposite lock, trying to get it to save. And then he's just pirouetting it round, blast the throttle. When I was driving, I would have been more thinking about getting the clutch, maybe from my junior series days when if the car stalled, you'd be out of the race. But Max isn't worried about that. He's just booting the throttle, trying to effectively donut the car back round. And through it comes. You can see on the dash there, all the LEDs are lit up. That means he has lost the car, basically. Anti-stall has kicked in. And in Formula One these days, that means that you get another chance to pull the clutch and go again. There he goes on the clutch, and he can accelerate his way back up to the final corner with only one place lost. And that in part is helped by Sergio Perez's teammate still running okay in the race, holding George Russell back behind. A strange spin, but well recovered from Max. And we've seen him do those sort of 360 spins quite a few times in races. He's got a good awareness of where the car is and making it back on track as quickly as possible.
DRS wide open for Max Verstappen once again. Verstappen is back ahead of Charles Leclerc. Max Verstappen from 10th on the grid comes home to win the Hungarian Grand Prix.
So that was a look as to how Max Verstappen managed to win the Grand Prix easily despite a spin from 10th on the grid. But there were other storylines to take away from Hungary as well. Another weekend to forget for Ferrari, Mercedes on the march, Lewis Hamilton getting another second place, and some great fighting between Alpine and Aston Martin, and more strong results for Lando Norris. Check it out on F1 TV.